What's up, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Soft Cell, going back to their 1981 album, Non-Stop Erotic Cabaret. It's been a great journey. Not only is it a bit darker than I may have expected, although, you know, once I got a couple tracks in, I got a real sense for the sort of dark and, I don't know, I like almost nihilistic sort of flavor. It's not quite nihilism, but it's sort of like this sardonic, jaded and sort of embittered, even though I think they were in their early 20s at this point. So yeah, it's a really interesting atmosphere and vibe to the album. I've enjoyed it a great deal. Sonically, it's like edgier and in some cases like faster than I would have expected. A lot of really cool synth work. I remember the synth work on Sex Dwarf was particularly memorable in the sense that not only was it a really cool sort of riff, but it reminded me of kind of like a trance riff, and then Kim pointed out that there's a track that, you know, I'd used in a mix not too long before that, that kind of had a similar sort of sounding melodic riff in it. So yeah, the different tracks along the way have been very enjoyable. We're up to a tune called Memorabilia. It's a single word title. You know, those are a bit harder to get a read on because it's not clear where the one word you do get might be heading. Memorabilia, it relates to like collectible items, you know, that commemorate something, but not in the way that a memorial does, where it's like a fixed position and it tends to be larger in scale and scope. It often is like publicly owned in terms of like it's not for someone to take home and to have as their own, whereas memorabilia is more something that is like for personal use or personal collection. It's, you know, tends to be smaller scale, tends to be, let's say, cheaper quality, or the production of it does not entail as much, you know, material resources or investment as one might see for a memorial. So memorabilia, you know, it speaks to like some item or some object that bears symbolic or representative relevance for something, whether that's, you know, a place or an event or, you know, a movement or some sort of, you know, an icon of some particular scene or group or, you know, religion, whatever it may be. So, I don't know, in the context of Soft Cell's album here, Non-Stop Erotic Cabaret, memorabilia, I'm inclined to think it'll have, you know, maybe a seedy or a, like, sordid or, like, a dark underbelly aspect to it, but it's not clear, just based on the one word, in what context that might manifest. So let's get to it. This is Soft Cell, Memorabilia, from their 1981 album Non-Stop Erotic Cabaret. Ooh, like a computer virus synth pop track. Thing to do and make it seem compelling, and then you pull it off. great commemoration. And that's like a picture of someone that you never really were with. It's like a postcard from a place you've never been. Monty Python thing, that there's a sketch, I think it's called like the tourist office or something like that, but it's Eric Idle and he goes to this tourist office and he's asking about like getting a adventure to India or like a adventure package vacation to India, but at some point he starts singing Torre Molina and like it felt like the way he said it there was like, wait, is that like an homage? But it could have been independent conversions. Regardless of that seeming connection, maybe only in my mind, yeah, I enjoyed it. Like I said, the first 45 seconds or so, it felt like, man, this is really kind of like dirty and gritty and like, you know, dissonant and sort of almost on the edge of like unpleasant. And as it went on, I came to appreciate the flavor more. Again, I'm not sure if I heard some of the lines right, but it does sound like it's someone who's sort of getting at the concept of, sorry, I thought I was going to sneeze, the idea of cheap plastic and maybe even inauthentic representations of memories and experiences, and the idea that I've never had you, which I think he said a couple times, it's the idea that like maybe, you know, this person who he's obsessing over, he never actually was intimate with them, so it's like weird to like, you know, have this commemoration of something that never actually came to fruition. And, you know, it made me think, and perhaps I think there was a line in the song, it's like a postcard for a place you've never been. So yeah, it felt like there was like a darker twist to the idea, but I'm not entirely certain, you know, what the like main sort of, you know, characters of the track are, if you will. Nevertheless, do let me know what you think of this one. I wouldn't say it's my favorite on the album, but I did enjoy it, and again, I like when songs take me on a journey like that, when they're sort of demanding and maybe a bit challenging to my ear at first, and then by the time I get to the end of the track, it's like, you know what, I'm glad I took that journey. So, that was the case there. Let me know if you agree. I will see you next time. Peace.